Does evolution provide a valid explanation for the existence of multicellular life, like animals and plants? Let's explore. Good day, everyone. In previous episodes, we explained that one of the most important features of theories are their ability to make predictions. A theory that makes useful prediction is a useful theory, but a theory that makes predictions that then turn out to be false, meaning that when you test those predictions in reality, you find that the predictions are in contradiction with reality. When the predictions are false, and the theory, by consequence, is false. The human body has 30 to 40 trillion cells. There are so many millions of multicellular organisms on this planet. So what is the explanation offered by the theory of evolution by natural selection? The theory claims that starting from the very first cell, which was obviously a single cell organism, until the human being, there has been a very gradual, very slow change. And through natural selection, the mutations that are more fit to survive are selected. So you have this organism, a more complex organism that has an advantage versus its competitive variants. So this one survives, and then another layer, and then another layer, and then another layer. Now, if we have this very complex creation, like the human being, a monkey, a lion, or a cat, or a mango tree, or an apple tree, and we have the starting point from a single cell, a necessary prediction is that we will have not only a single-celled organism, and then an organism with millions and billions and trillions of cells, but we will also have an organism that is made of two cells. Not two cells sitting together, or 1,000 cells sitting together in a colony, each one of them is an independent creature. No, a two-celled organism, and then three-celled organisms, and then four-celled organisms. And each of these cells is an integral and an essential part of the organism. This cell is doing this function, and this other cell is doing this other function. And then, as more evolution takes place, cells get more specialized, they magically arrange themselves into organs, and each organ will do a specific function. They magically communicate the product of each organ and gives it to the other organs so that the whole organism survives, and so forth and so forth, and you end up with the kind of organisms that we see. So this is the prediction. So my question to you, how many two-celled organisms did you hear about? Please name 10 of them. There are millions of organisms on this planet. The latest estimate of 2011 was 8.7 million. Let's say there are 10 million, okay? Of which like 1.6 million have been cataloged. Let's say there are 10 million. There is essentially millions of multicellular organisms, animals and plants, for example, and millions of single-celled organisms. Where are the millions of two-cell, three-cell, four-cell, five-cell, six-cell, 10-cell, 100-cell, 200-cell organisms? Where are they? And you cannot give the answer of, they perished. Why? Because since they formed, since natural selection gave them the leeway to form, it means they had an advantage. They are better than their predecessors, and their predecessor is a single-celled organism. And if single-celled organisms still persist and exist till today, then their successors would rather be here today, because if they're not here today, the single cell survived and the two-cell organism did not survive, it means it shouldn't have persisted and survived or existed anyway. It should have been ruled out by natural selection, and life should have stayed at single-celled organisms. The question is, why do you accept a theory that tells you that a 30 to 40 trillion cell organism, like the human being, or any other animal or plant that have trillions of cells, exist from the first cell through evolution? And you're not asking this question. Where is the answer that the theory is offering? Please do your research. Please look around into scientific papers, like I have gone here and there, and you will find that there is no answer. The reason is, there is no such evolution. If you have evidence that 3 or 4 or 5 or 10 or 100 cell organisms existed, please show me. Please show yourself before believing in a theory that not only does not provide evidence, but provides predictions that are in total contradiction with reality and with what they claim to be the fossil record that confirms the validity of the theory of evolution by natural selection. I leave you with the thought to continue the journey to find truth and to verify whether we are the product of randomness and blindness, or we are creations created here by purpose and intent by the supreme being that we call God. Thank you.